Define your genetic structure. Pick your fur type. Choose your fur style. Pick your mane color. Choose your detail color. Good choice. Adventure is in the air, despite the heart-numbing frost and icy draft from the mountain below. Oh no, they got you! Reeled in and off to a bad start. Tribes are out for Skronky Scrap. Your Whifflin is up next. A tribe tug-of-war. Struggle, bet you can do just that. Got one! The tribe's caught a fluffy hulk. Better watch out, it's no pet. I knew it! They couldn't be down! Fluff hulks on the loose! Melee Super Wushu is ready to go! That emergency kit is from the old days when you needed to pack a punch to survive. Wow, bet that knuck makes a tight fist. Tools like this still carry echoes from the past. Can you hear? Choo-choo! The Chug Yard, where they parked the choo-choos and fueled them up. It's one of the few places that's aged well. It used to look like a dump. It's easy to walk the line when your karma is in balance. Spilled liquid soap is always a slippery slope. Who'd expect that? A bubble wobble big enough to go bang! A tribe flip-flonker will throw you in at the deep end given a chance. You hit it! Neutralized. Blast
everything to bits.
This box once tailed a chugger-chugger. Now, it's just off track. Tribes all were scavenging for scrap, but they should have stuck. Bumper Bunker's busy ram-banging the door. This is your chance.
Not how you left your battle.
Super Wushu is locked and loaded. Better defuse that sprocket before it blows up in your face. You can do anything. Only the sky is the limit. Now, let's take this back to Earth. Wow, you really took that all the way down to the end. In flames. It's a wonder some of these up and down still work. Guess they built machines better in the past. I need to brush up on my Wongo, but I think he says he's surprised the tribe got a sprocket off ground. I have a feeling he believes it was you that caused the bang at the yard. Not sure he's happy about that. Anyways, he says you owe him one, and he has something in mind. He's almost done with his latest creation, a Mecton. He just needs a little more scrap to get all the pieces fixed-stucked.
Why not talk?
Please, don't ask him too many questions. Wando is an old language, and the last time I heard it was in the old village.
Popong Pippi-Loo.
I think he likes you. From what I can tell, he wants to strike a deal. He also says you owe him one.
Popong Pippi-Loo.
He can't leave his underyard, so if you help him salvage the scrap he needs from an old skronk just outside, he'll let you take the Mecton for a ride into the dead zone. They're short of breath and death to this zone. Better take care. He who half breathes, half lives. For those that work metal, scrap from mech skronks like this are heavyweight. There are only a few reasons our world is dying, and all of them could have been avoided. The muckwumps are sly, patiently waiting for prey beneath the dead oil surface. The grease monkey's Mecton is built sturdy, just like himself. Can you imagine how this place used to look before the dead oil flood? In the old world, roads like this really led somewhere. Now, most of them lead to disaster. That's a jumbo puff with an appetite. Ain't no parts of better put an end before it ends our world. You can't take much more. That won't be the treasure that you left to reuse the pump. Jumbo Puff is picking it up a notch. It's time for an electric performance. Blasting everything to place. Bad feeling about this. It goes all the way down to the start. Start like a snack and you'll end with a ride down the intestinal canal. That's too close to the end station. Better move on. Up and away. You'll be swept out the bowels. Look at you. No doubt. From this point on, there's no way forward but going back in. Too close to the end station. Better move on. Up and away, you'll be swept out the bowel way. Wow, what a super sight! The tourist! Who would have guessed it would go down with a throw-up? Can it really get any better than that? And as one plague ends, hope for a new beginning lives on. The Tree of Life still stands, with the fate of the world in your hands. Question is, will you continue to defend it, or end it? Guess we'll just have to wait to find out, won't we?